U.S. Navy just destroyed West Point Commie in the best way possible. The annual Army-Navy football game was held in Philadelphia on Saturday, and while there is always some good-natured ribbing between the rival service academies, this year it seemed a bit more pointed than usual. It would appear that the U.S. Navy's midshipmen hadn't forgotten about the pictures that circulated online a few months back, which featured a graduate of the West Point Military Academy, Army 2nd Lieutenant Spencer Arpoon, wearing a Che Guevara shirt under his uniform and a note inside his cap that read "Communism will win." According to the Daily Caller, some of the midshipmen hung a banner which boldly declared "not communists," and one individual was spotted holding up a sign that read "Communism won't win." As if that wasn't enough, it was reported that whenever the Army cadets would attempt to get a chant started, the midshipmen would respond by repeatedly yelling "communists" at them. Newsmax reported that Arpoon had not only posted the pictures of himself online, but had also made disparaging remarks about Defense Secretary James Mattis, among other top officials, and had declared himself a member of the Democratic Socialists of America political party. The social media activity by Arpoon has led many to believe that he stands in violation of the Uniform Code of Military Justice, specifically Article 88. That article reads that any commissioned officer who uses contemptuous words against the President, the Vice President, Congress, the Secretary of Defense, the Secretary of a Military Department, the Secretary of Transportation, or the governor or legislature of any state, territory, commonwealth, or possession in which he is on duty or present shall be punished as a court-martial may direct. Many people, including Republican Florida Senator Marco Rubio, have called for Arpoon to be decommissioned from the military, and furthermore be compelled to reimburse taxpayers for his tuition and other expenses at the military academy. It remains unclear at this time what, if any, sort of punishment Arpoon, who graduated from West Point in May 2016, has received for the behavior that riled up so many Americans who despise communism. According to the Army Times, an official statement from West Point in September said, "Second Lieutenant Arpoon's actions in no way reflect the values of the U.S. Military Academy or the U.S. Army." It was further reported that Arpoon had been assigned to the U.S. Army's 10th Mountain Division, and though the division supports freedom of speech, indeed, its members have fought and bled and died to defend it over the years, its command structure nevertheless noted that it was against regulations for service members to make political statements while in uniform. The 10th Mountain Division not only supports free speech, it trains every day to ensure our nation has the ability to protect it at all cost, stated Lieutenant Colonel Tanu Stokes, according to Army Times. That being said, when our soldiers are in uniform, politics must be set aside. Our uniform represents every corner of our nation and it cannot be used to promote any single ideology. As figures of public trust, members of the military must exhibit exemplary conduct and are prohibited from engaging in certain expressions of political speech in uniform. The Army and Navy are well known for giving each other a hard time whenever their annual rivalry game comes around, but this year, the Navy wins first prize for hilariously trolling their brothers in arms, even if they did ultimately lose the game to Army by 1 point, 14-13.